years we've had a mix of different programmes. So we've had graduate programmes with GMIT students, and then we've had more recently artists who kind of approached me to talk about wanting to do something specific, more about the developmental of a specific project, and they're both more established than artists we would have worked with on the graduate programme. So we've had Noel Argan, we've had Ruth Laguerre, we've had graduates like Roisin O'Sullivan, Majella Dowdigan, and we've had Ruby Wallace in here as well. So it really depends on what the artist needs, but one of the main things that we can all kind of agree on that they need is space. So that's what we could give them. There's always a lot of intrigue as to what goes on behind the closed door of the artist's studio. And there is this kind of idea of kind of the artist in the kind of attic. And a lot of times you go into an artist's studio and it's a computer on a desk. So it is interesting to see what goes on in a studio, and then to have work from a studio organisation downstairs. So Jennifer is working with a mixture of painting, drawing, video, photography, and they all kind of work together. So you'll have some elements that kind of sit in the background, like the photography element, and then you have the video work that is being developed further as its own work, but you can see that it does really relate to the paintings, and that there's a dialogue between the different media, and there's different ideas being presented, even though it all fits under the one project. It's not that Jennifer is kind of going, oh, look what I can do in painting now, I can do the same idea in a different medium. She's using each medium to explore different things and really pushing it. Mix of kind of very loose mark making with some very specific drawing overlaid, or you'll have the video making by its very nature of how you actually do it has to be quite tight. You kind of have to know what you're doing before you do it, but she still manages to make it quite loose, so that there is room for the viewer there to kind of explore. It's not just a very strict narrative. And I think one of the reasons why people engage with Jennifer's work and really connect with it is that they can see their own lives in this. Like with the protagonists, you have these kind of girls in transition in some areas, or kind of younger, or these kind of groups of women that just seem to be kind of left to their own devices and kind of left to figure out the world. And I think a lot of people can relate to that. And they can be quite small in relation to their surroundings. They can look quite unsure of themselves in relation to this very kind of strong architecture or these other structures. So there's just a really nice dynamic going on, and it's something I think that the audience can really run with. And there's always this unease and this tension that I think has really found its place in her video work as well, because I think people they find that kind of tension and surrealism quite interesting in film sense, and of course there's a long history of that in film.